I'm Brian Westbrook with GeekWire Studios here at AWS reInvent 2025 in Las Vegas, joined now by AMD's Director of Worldwide Cloud Business Group, Mike Thompson. Mike, great to see you again.
Brian, nice to see you again. Thanks for having me.
AMD has a lot of great developments with the EC2 instances. How do they help AWS customers increase performance while cutting costs?
Yeah, there's been a lot of developments with AMD and our EPYC processors, as well as our Instinct GPUs. For the CPUs, the EPYC processors, there's a number of features, and you really need to look at those instances in two ways. One side of the portfolio are meant for performance-driven optimizations. So the CPUs are very high performance. That enables them to run applications that are faster runtime, smaller footprint, or smaller instance size. And it's that faster runtime, smaller footprint, smaller instance size that enables the cost to be optimized. And then on the other side of the portfolio, so those would be for 7A and 8A instances. Yeah. With our 6A instances, those are really intended for hourly cost optimizations. So for applications that just need to run all day long, they're available at 10% to 45% lower cost worldwide.
So the idea here is to have different instances available for different optimization strategies depending on your workload, depending on what you're trying to do. Could you give us some examples of maybe what would go in 6A, 7A, 8A?
Yeah, so let's say, we'll start with a simple one. So let's say you have a simple login daemon, a server that's just sitting around waiting for someone to log in. It has to run 24/7, 365. You can't do 24 hours a day any faster.
Right.
But for other applications, like an on-demand database serving recommendations of someone, that has to be high performance. So for applications that are performance limited, they benefit from the 7th generation and the 8th generation instances powered by AMD and AWS.
I love that. Now let's talk about technical advances and real-world benefits of 5th gen AMD EPYC-powered EC2 instances. Latest and greatest, what's new?
There's been a lot of announcements this week at reInvent on the 8th generation instances. Those are powered by, like you said, our 5th generation EPYC processors. We call those Turin processors. And AWS said that they enable a 30% generation over generation performance uplift, and that comes from a number of features. Number one, 4.5 gigahertz clock speed, so really, really fast. That helps enable lower latency and higher throughput. 45% increase in memory bandwidth, which also increases response time, especially for applications that have users hanging off of the application, interacting with it real time. And on top of that, there's a number of new instance types covering a kind of a gamut of all the various features that can be enabled on EC2 instances, from Z high-speed instances to N network-enhanced instances where there's more bandwidth to increase the throughput for inter-node communication, to local disk-attached instances, and I'm forgetting one. And high memory to vCPU ratio. So typically we have 2, 4, and 8 gigabyte per vCPU instances available. Well, in this generation, AWS decided to release some instance where you have 32 gigabytes per vCPU. The kind of applications that benefit from those are applications like EDA and relational databases that benefit from having a lot of the database immediately adjacent to the processor.
Right there for you. Now, how are you building trust as an AI partner with AWS? I know the two of you have a symbiotic relationship that goes back over a lot of years. How is that happening and what's new in that space?
So there's a number of new things. So one thing to think about AMD, we're not a one type of supplier. We actually cover the whole gamut. If you imagine an AI cluster, it's more than GPUs, it's more than CPUs, which AMD supplies both of. We also have optimized networking products in order to run those clusters, as well as something like a smart NIC that's able to offload the processors from having to do overhead and stay focused on the task at hand in order to maximize throughput. And in addition, we also have reconfigurable coprocessors in order to maximize performance. And so we really cover the gamut end to end of what an AI cluster really needs. Now, when it comes to security and trust, AMD's processors are built with security in mind from the very beginning. They're designed to have security front and center from the beginning, from secure boot, with a hardware-based root of trust actually in the silicon. It's not some external thing, to attestation, which is a way for a software application that's running on these processors can actually talk to the hardware to verify that it's legitimate and hasn't been cloned and hacked or something like that, as well as building in secure communication channels, so it protects the data all the way around.
Now, a lot of great announcements, a lot of great products here at this year's re:Invent, but looking forward, what does AMD have on the roadmap ahead? What sort of developments and improvements can we expect? It seems like everything is getting faster, more cost efficient, and certainly consuming less power, but what's on the horizon? Where are you thinking ahead?
There's a couple of things. AMD is investing tremendously into our software ecosystem to support AI and enable compatibility with other ecosystems in the market, so that's a big one. And then from a cloud perspective, we are putting a lot of effort into expanding our partner ecosystem so that more of our partners are able to bring the value of AMD to more customers quickly and easily. Our aim is to make it a point and click enablement, solution enablement flow.
It sounds like there are some really exciting things ahead. Look forward to chatting with you next year. Of course, that's Mike Thompson, Worldwide Cloud Business Group with AMD. I'm Brian Westbrook with GeekWire Studios.